Hello everyone, viklasthemad here. Eagle-eyed viewers among you will notice that there are some new things here in the base area, specifically up on top of the base hill. That's right, there's a jungle. Turns out that Misnik and or Niatra had found a jungle some time ago, and it just completely slipped their mind to, tell anyone. But yeah, they found a village way, 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 way out away from everybody else. There's a portal to it in the Nether, and it's hooked up to the tunnel network that we've got down there. But yeah, just to the west, no, the east, just to the east of it, there's a jungle. So, headed on out there. Got us some saplings, got some jungle trees planted here in the base. And as you can see there, got one giant one there behind me there, and two regular sized ones. That one turned out really short. Got some cocoa beans while we were out there. And I've got cocoa beans growing on every available surface on both of the single wide jungle trees there. So eventually, well, no, I'm gonna leave that until just a little bit. We've got a book here, and I'm gonna start doing a new thing in every episode. We're gonna start off with the little introduction, and then we're gonna go into this little book and quill here. We're gonna open it up, and it's gonna give us the list of things that we're gonna do in today's episode. So let's open it up and see what we've got. All right, first of all, we're going to show off the map. I'm working on a map wall for everybody here on the realm to be able to look at. Right now it's sitting here inside my base area, but it's going to be moved eventually over to the over to spawn, and it's going to be sitting right outside of the bookstore. Seems like a fitting place for it. Then I'm going to show you the improved Blaze Farm. I'm going to show you the improvements that I've made over there. I was going to show you that in the last episode, but had to cut that out due to time. So I was actually going to show you, I was actually going to have a little chat with you while I was actually working on it, but that just went all kinds of wrong. Got some future projects that we're going to talk about throughout the episode. And probably just going to make a general fool of myself, and I might get some light enchanting done because we're going to get some levels while we're over in the Blaze Farm. So yeah. Also, quick thing to note, the expanded and improved mob farm over here is actually producing quite well. So yeah. I've got 24 levels here, and that's after using up a bunch of levels to grab myself the projectile protection 4 on my diamond chest plate. So I've got all my bases covered, really. I've got fire protection 4 here, projectile here, blast protection here, and here. And I got the feather falling on the boots too. Ideally what I'd like to have is I'd like to get another set done, and I've got more than enough diamonds to do it. I want to get another set done that's all just protection 4, with the exception of maybe leggings with blast protection 4. I'll just keep those leggings right there. But what I do want to do with this set is I want to get that thorns up to 3. I want to get thorns 3 on each piece that can take it, and I also need to get unbreaking on this chest plate, because it is currently the only piece of armor I've got, the only piece of anything that I've got really, that does not have unbreaking 3. Doesn't have any level of unbreaking, as a matter of fact. So first things first, I said I was going to show you the map. So let's go ahead and head down here over to the map wall in progress. So far I've got just the road area mapped out here, and here we go. Right here is spawn. That's the crossroads for spawn, and you can see my little lily pad road that goes over there to the towards the currently not functioning low yield slime farm. We got Rodimus's makeshift village there. That's the bookstore there, so didn't really realize how big that actually was until I popped the map up and I was like, oh wow, look at that. I got the sheep pen there and a little stable over there where I got the horse that anyone can take. Then the road goes on up. We got Misnick's mob farm up there, his mob grinder, with base area that he's working on up on top of it. His original base tower right there and his animal pens right there. Further on up the road, we got our base up there, all nice and fenced in. You can actually see the fence line. If I were up higher, you'd be able to see the fence line that goes all the way around. And you get to see just how big of a plot we've got picked out here. And really, it's not all that, it's not too terribly big when you consider that it's actually about the same size as the top of Misnick's mob grinder there. It's also roughly the same size. It's a little bit bigger than Neatra's village over here, and that's, I mean, that's her village. So, even though it gets a lot of foot traffic, especially for me. And we got Zelenia's place down here. She's got a glass tower with all kinds of things going on inside that square. And then there's her chicken pit. And the road continues on south down into the desert, but you can't really see because it blends in. And then we got the west road here. We got Seraphin and J.Arg are over here, and I'm not sure who that belongs to. And then over here at the very end, we have the stronghold. So that's the map wall as it is now. Eventually, we're going to fill in all the block, all the gaps, and it's just going to be it's going to be an 8x10 wall that's going to end up getting put up, and I think it's going to look really nice. So I'm just checking my time there. So yeah, I'm going to take a. Oh, and I had to make a crap load of paper. A metric butt ton of paper to get all those maps made, and so I moved some of the sugar cane out here. We still got the sugar cane being produced inside the base with all the rest of the crops in there, but 60 sugar cane every like it was taking like 15 to 20 minutes for it all to grow back completely. It wasn't cutting it, so I brought this out here and we got a 40 long, 40 block long thing here, line here of sugarcane. And that really helped out. So got it done pretty quick. I was going to do it as an episode in and of itself. But it was just, there was just way too much going on and I've actually had some complaints that my exploration videos were boring. So I didn't want to make it look like that, didn't want to make it look like exploration, and I didn't feel like that was something that I really wanted to fast forward through. So I just said, eh, skip it, and decided that we'd just go with like a review. So gonna make a quick cut here and we're gonna go into the Nether for the Blaze Farm. See you in a bit. So here we are at the Blaze Farm, and this is such a safe and secure thing that we're going to go ahead and take all the armor off. Now, I say this is safe and secure because whenever Blaze spawns in here, it will only spawn up on these raised platforms, and the way it's raised and with this row, oh, where'd that guy go? There he is. With this row of, or with this layer rather of half slabs above you, there's only a half block space that they can that anything can be seen through, and you can look up and see them, but they cannot look down and see you. So they do not aggro, they do not turn on their flame. Oh, hello. A magma cube out there. I'm gonna put my arm back on. I want to take care of him. Okay, but anyway, serious business time now. Serious business time. I'm gonna take the armor back off because, again, like I said, this is 100% safe in here. I've been hit a couple of times, but I've never been set on fire since this got put together. There's a bunch of blazes right there, and the bow is fixed. That's another thing I like about this is I can fix my equipment when I come down here, gain a bunch of levels. What I really like about blazes is the flat 10 XP, the flat 10 experience that they're worth. So that they drop 2 experience orbs, and they're 5 experience each. So I've got an ender chest here, and I can store all my little goodies in there. So we're gonna do that. But yeah, getting those eight magma creams, that's helpful. What with the slime farm being broken. And like I said, I got plenty of diamonds here to make that next set of diamond armor, my backup set. I'm thinking I'm gonna make a set that's I'm thinking the set that I was talking about, rather, is probably something that I would use if I do a wither fight. And I do have one wither skull. I'm trying to get more. I would really like to have a beacon. And I think I'm one of the only people on our realm that's really got the drive to do it. But anyway, okay, so one project that I was looking at doing in the not too distant future, maybe even in the next episode, is since I've got not an overabundance, but enough slimes, I can make some sticky pistons. I was thinking about making a ooh, and it's dark out there. Let's go for it. I was thinking about making a oh, get him, get him. Bring it. All right. Anyway, distracted myself there. I was thinking about making a an automated sort of cocoa farm. And I think I might do the same thing. I might make some other slightly automated farms as well. I might make automated-ish pumpkin and melon farm. Those would be vertical stacks that will come off of a design from one of the Hermitcraft guys. And then the cocoa bean farm, I've got a design of my own that I want to use, and it's modular, so I can make it as big or as small as I want it to be, and it's expandable in multiple ways. And there is a witch in my farm. So another thing, iron farm. Gonna make an iron farm. Probably gonna put it out here in the lake. And the way I'm gonna do it is I'm going to lure some zombie villagers in here and get them trapped in a space, and then convert them. I've got the material. I've got all the materials to do that. I think. I'm pretty sure. Because I'm pretty sure I can brew up. I know I can make splash potions because I got plenty of gunpowder. I'm pretty sure I can make potions of weakness. And I know that I can make a lot of golden apples. So, yeah. That's not going to be a problem. I can convert zombie villagers. I just need to get some wrangled up in here. And get them trapped, and then it'll be good to go. I'll probably just start with 2, and then corral them into an area out there on the lake, which will be a bit of a pain. But I got rails, and I can make mine carts. Actually, I can borrow a couple of mine carts from some places. But yeah. I can just minecart them out to a platform on the lake, and then trap them in there and build some doors, build a bunch of doors, and then have probably like a lava blade kind of thing going on, that the iron golems that they will produce eventually will just get killed by lava, and their drop, lava up top, because golems are tall, and then the iron that they drop will be lower than that, and it'll drop into hoppers for automatic collection. So yeah, I'll get that going. Yeah, it's going to be interesting getting the villagers bred and getting enough of them out there to start making making golems, and then they're going to replenish the golem every now and then on their own, and probably just going to have enough of them to make one golem, maybe two. I don't know. I don't know how many you need to make however many golems, but I'll do the research on that I need to, and I'll get working on that at some point. Probably going to brew up the weakness potions and make the golden apples before I actually get started on that. On building any on any construction. But yeah, eventually you're going to finish out the map. That is a project to work on. I got a lot of space to fill in. I got two blocks up there to fill. And then we're going to come down here. We're going to do 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 more maps and item frames there. And then we got this 3, 6, 9, 12. 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, there, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, and then that's plus this, which was 40, so 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52. So 54, got 54 maps and item frames to still make to make this the 8x10 block. I think it's 8x10. Let me count that out real quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ah, poop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, yep, that's 10. And then this should be 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, so 8 by 10, 10 by 8, however you want to say it. It's going to be an 8 by 10 landscape-oriented map wall. So, and it'll go at spawn, and it'll go up on a platform. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to remake two maps. I'm going to remake the one right here where we're standing, so that that green dot isn't on that one. And then I'm going to remake the spawn one, because the last time that I took this one out for a reference to get this map, when I took it down off the wall, it did not show my position on it anymore. So if I take that off, you'll see the little dot is not there. It's not there. I really do like that you can do this though with maps, which is nice, but you can't right click to put it back on there, so you gotta put it back in your main hand, which is in both hands, and then put it back on there. But that's okay. Oh no, I'm gonna have to redo that one. I just noticed that corner isn't fully filled in. Okay, so I've got three maps to redo, but that's not so bad. Plus the 50 some that I need to do to fill in the space that isn't covered. But other than that, yeah, we're good. So, and not all of our players are going to be on this map, but that's because like Hawk is, if I put Hawk on here and all the space out to him, I think I'd be like down there, either down at the fence or maybe even up against the stone generator. So that's not an option. And then we've got some other players. Like, there's actually a village that would be probably about here, that some people are in. But I'm not going to go out that far, at least not for a while. Maybe way later I'll come back and I'll expand the map out that way, far enough to get that village. But I don't know. And then I'm also not going to get Misnik and Neatra's other village that's got the jungle nearby. So, but yeah, that's pretty much that. So, and no, that's not on on leaves. I cut the leaves down and put cobblestone there. So, hey, remember where I said make a fool of myself? I'm rambling, so I'm doing it. Don't know about enchanting though. Don't think I'm gonna get any enchanting done. In this episode, I don't even know what I would enchant. I can enchant some books, but the last time I put a book on the enchanting table to see what it would come out with, it was yuck. It was things I didn't need, didn't want. It was just ugly. So, not gonna do that. So yeah. Pumpkin farm, melon farm, cocoa farm, iron farm. And then, based on that and seeing how much space I have left, I may do an industrial super smelter, which, if I do that, I'm going to do it in the base. And do I have enough time? Yes, I do, just barely. I'm going to run in here. I'm going to show you real quick exactly where I'm going to. Ah, no. Where I would put that. That slowed me down a little bit. Come in here. So if I do an industrial smelter, super smelter, what I'm going to do is I'm going to tear out all this farm area, and I'm going to put it in here. But I would leave the logs because they look cool. But yeah, I'd tear all these farms out, and I'd put the super smelter there. But I don't even know if I'm going to do that, so we'll see. I'm going to take a quick cut and I'll see you in a little bit. Okay, so we're back outside. I've put down some signs. Over here we've got future site for industrial cocoa farm, which means probably that tree and most definitely this tree are going to have to go. That one's also probably going to have to go because we have here behind the map wall's current position, future site for industrial pumpkin farm. So cocoa farm over there, pumpkin farm over here. Right across the road from it, future site for industrial melon farm, and then way out here in the middle of the lake, I found a hole. Way out here in the middle of the lake, future site for iron farm. I don't want to say industrial iron farm because that makes it sound like it's going to be like high production, high quality. It's not. It's going to be low production, and it's pretty much going to be for me. The pumpkin farm, the melon farm, and the cocoa farm, those are going to be for whoever wants it. But the iron, that's going to be mine. I'm going to check that thing like every time I get on. And, once it goes up, I'm going to check it every time I'm on, frequently while I'm on, even, and collect the iron from it. Because I don't know if you noticed, but if you watch through my episodes, I usually get into my ender chest at least once, often more than once. And the ender chest is currently where I've got all my valuables, and I consider iron a valuable. That reminds me. Forgot that I had these in there. We'll take those out. And I'm probably going to craft some of these into blocks soon so that I can save some space. Because I'm not going to do any trading anytime soon. But when I do, it's going to be a lot of coal. But yeah, this is all the iron I have. I had more. I had like out to here and almost a full stack at that. But it's all, it was all ingots, no blocks. I made a bunch of compasses. I lost count how many compasses I actually made. I think I only bought like three or four, and then the rest of them for those maps I made. And that's four iron per compass. And then I also made that anvil that I just put down off camera in the Nether, next to the Blaze Farm. And I put that there because, I'll for myself, what I'll do is I'll come in and I'll gain a bunch of levels that I need to enchant something, and then I'll end up running back to the base here and picking up the enchanted book that I'm gonna use, and pick up the item, and if I don't already have it on me, and then I'm gonna throw it on an anvil. Well, why not cut out the middleman? I'll put the enchanted book in the ender chest. I've got an ender chest at the Blaze Farm. I just go into the Blaze Farm, get the experience, and use the anvil that's right there outside of it, and go ahead and enchant up whatever it is I'm enchanting. So, next thing that I'm going to work on getting enchantment-wise, though, is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get those thorns. I'm going to get those thorns enchantments, and I think somewhere out there, I don't remember exactly where, there's a librarian that has thorns as an enchanted book, not as pre-enchanted armor. So, I'm going to get those thorns enchantment books and combine them on the anvil to make them into Thorns 3, and then put Thorns 3 on whatever can take it, which I think thorns can go on all your armor, so I'm gonna be all thorny. Right. Anyway, that's unfortunate placement of that torch. but yeah, that's all I've got time for today. I know this was a very chatty episode. Didn't really get anything built. I didn't have anything. Didn't plan on having anything to be built this episode. And I don't think I said in the last episode that I was going to be building anything. But I'll go back and I'll watch that again and see if I, in fact, did say that. And if I did, then whatever it is that I said that we'd build, we'll do on Saturday. Yeah, we'll do a Saturday's episode. But if that's not the case, then Saturday's episode will probably be one of those industrial farms. Like, I don't know, probably go with the cocoa farm first. We'll do the cocoa farm. That'll be the first one. So if I didn't promise you something for today, out of this episode, then we'll do that. But if I did, if I was supposed to be building something this episode, then yeah, we'll do that on Saturday's episode instead. Last couple things I want to mention. Still need names for the animals. Got name tags galore. Got like three times as many name tags, maybe four times as many name tags as I need for all the animals. But I got eight horses, donkey, skeletal horse, and the dog that I want named. All of those need names. Can't think of any names for any of them. Well, except for one horse. One horse. I'm kind of settled on one name, but I'm not sure. If I hear a better suggestion for it, then I'll take it. But yeah, if I don't have any suggestions by the end of, oh, let's see, June? Yeah. Well, no, May. May. If I don't have any suggestions by the end of May for any of these animals, for their names, I'm just gonna start naming them stuff. I'm just gonna be like, first thing that pops into my head, that's your name now. Like, I'll name the skeletal horse after one of the guys that I saw in one of my World of Warships matches. His name was Foodle Bob. I'll name the skeletal horse Foodle Bob. And I'll start naming some of the animals after some of my friends and after some of my favorite fictional characters, and yeah, it'll just be, you know, that. But if I get some suggestions before the end of May, for any names, then I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna do those. Also, like I mentioned in my last episode, might be losing the internet soon. That's gonna suck. It's gonna make it really hard to do certain things. Like, I'm gonna have to go somewhere where I can use Wi-Fi to do my Minecrafting. I'm gonna have to go somewhere where I've got internet to do World of Tanks and World of Warships. And if I start throwing Armored Warfare on here, because I still gotta get around to doing the replay system on there. If I start doing that, then I gotta go somewhere where I got internet for that too. So I might be losing the internet. If you want to help me keep my internet on, please, please donate to me so that I can stay on here and keep doing this. Support this channel. Support the guy who's doing it. Please, please, I'm begging you. See, I'm begging. I'm begging. Look at the adorable little wolfy face there. I'm begging you. But yeah, seriously, I am begging. I'm unashamedly begging. Please, if you've got anything to donate, if you would, please donate. My Patreon is linked down in the video description on every episode of everything, every video that I put out since I opened up my Patreon. And if you've got any other ways that you want to donate to support the channel and support me, then get a hold of me. My email contact is down there as well. Get a hold of me on that. It's viklasthemad@gmail.com. Hit me up on that. It's down in the video description as well. So yeah, let me know down there if you don't want to use Patreon or can't use Patreon or whatever. So yeah, that's that. So I need names for the animals, financial support, keep me going, you know, keep this going, support the channel. Yeah, projects coming down the pipe. So tomorrow is World of Tanks. And so until then, we'll see you. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.